The creator of Desperate Housewives returns to give us a brand new soapy show with CBS All Access's Why Women Kill. This dark comedy has an all-star cast and a crazy concept, but is it really worth watching? Keep listening for my thoughts on the pilot episode and if it's something to add to your weekly rotation. CBS All Access is pulling out all the stops to become a main player in the streaming network wars. They've already brought us a brand new Star Trek show and will soon expand upon that franchise. They've also brought us a follow-up to The Good Wife and their original shows like Strange Angel. Why Women Kill is their newest original series, and at the time of this recording, the pilot episode is free to watch on YouTube. I have to admit I wasn't particularly interested in this show, but free is free, and I thought I'd give it a view just to see how it measures up. The show comes from Mark Cherry, who created ABC's wildly successful Desperate Housewives and the lesser-known Lifetime series Devious Maids. I definitely remember how crazy everybody was for Desperate Housewives when it was airing, and I can just imagine that CBS All Access is banking on fans of the show to tune into this one. The show takes us through three time periods with three different relationships and how they may ultimately end in murder. The series takes place in the same Pasadena house starting in 1963. It bounces back between this era as well as the 80s and present day, featuring the drama going on with its owners. As of the pilot episode, there doesn't seem to be any connection between the characters, although I thought it would be interesting if they chose to link them up as the season goes on. Ginnifer Goodwin, who you may know from shows like Big Love and Once Upon a Time, plays Beth Ann, a classic housewife in the 60s. She and her husband move into a new home, and it's obvious from the start that she has little more to do with her life but attend to her husband. A neighborhood couple introduces themselves, and it's not long before they realize that all is not well with Beth Ann and her husband. We eventually find out that Beth Ann's husband is cheating on her with a waitress at a diner close to his work. Now, timid Beth Ann doesn't understand how to deal with all of this and ends up taking the advice of her new friend and confronting her husband's girlfriend. She does come face to face with her and ends up not being able to accuse her of infidelity. In fact, it looks as if she's going to befriend her. I absolutely love Ginnifer Goodwin, and I've been a big fan of her various shows, so I was glad to see her cast in something new. I didn't watch much of Desperate Housewives, but her character greatly reminds me of Marcia Cross's character on that show, right down to the red hair and the Stepford Wife personality. I can already tell that a lot of Ginnifer's storyline is going to be about setting her free and gaining a purpose in life outside of her cheating husband. My money, though, is on her as the first to snap and kill him. Lucy Liu's character Simone is a three-time married 80s socialite that appears to be the life of the party. She finds out, thanks to a vengeful neighbor, that her husband has been having an affair with another man. Simone is outraged, but wanting to keep everything quiet as to not lose her social standing. She eventually ends up stopping her husband from overdosing and then begins a fling with her friend's teenage son. This storyline was by far the most amusing in the episode, with an over-the-top 80s setting, and Lucy's actually really funny, and several of her lines made me laugh out loud. The affair with the teenage boy, though, was straight out of Desperate Housewives when Eva Longoria slept with her gardener. The present-day aspect of the show actually tended to focus more on the husband than the wife. Eli, who is a struggling screenwriter, is married to feminist attorney Taylor. Now, she made it clear when they met that she was bisexual, and the two have an open marriage that allows her to continue this aspect of her sexuality. Things get interesting when one of Taylor's hookups ends up in need of a place to stay when her boyfriend goes a little nuts. Much to Eli's objections, Taylor invites Jade to stay with them, and that's when things get a little awkward. Eli finds himself very attracted to Jade and confused on if she's wanting something with both of them. Now, honestly, this storyline was the least interesting to me, and I couldn't see where this one was going to go dark. Taylor and Eli seemed pretty solid with their arrangement, and adding in Jade just made me think the show's going to explore a polyamorous relationship. Obviously, someone is going to get jealous along the way, but I'm not sure it would lead to murder. Outside of the lovely actress playing Jade, I could have skipped through this storyline. Now, obviously, the promos for the show made us think that these women will eventually kill their husbands, but the episode made it very clear that it was just about women and why they would kill, not necessarily their husbands. In all three storylines, there are more than one target that could possibly end up dead. If you enjoy campy shows like Desperate Housewives or maybe even daytime soap operas, then I think this is going to be a show for you. It was definitely a dark comedy with lots of unconventional jokes that were funny, but for me, I'm not sure I'd continue with the show. I think it may be one of those that's best binged instead of week to week. I really did like the cast and the setting of the show, and I think it could be really interesting if they managed to connect all the timelines together outside just being in the same house. I wondered at one point if they were all going to be related and the house was passed down from generation to generation, but I'm thinking probably not, considering none of the couples had children and it didn't seem to be expecting any. So for me, this isn't going to be something I add into my weekly shows, but I could revisit it once the show has aired and just catch the whole season. Anyways, that's going to be my review of the first episode. If it sounded interesting to you, then by all means go out and check it out on YouTube while it's free, and maybe it's something you'll like. Thanks for watching. I've got several more reviews coming out over the next few days. As we approach the new fall season, there's going to be a ton of new shows out there to try, so definitely stay tuned.